Hey guys, this is Far Amazing Adventures. Right now I'm actually at a place called the D-Day, the National D-Day Memorial, excuse me. It's actually located in Bedford, Virginia, which is a small town located on the, that's really nested out in the valley. It's a small town, just, you know, not a lot of people know about. People know about Lynchburg, Virginia, or Roanoke, Virginia, but Bedford is one of those small towns that not a lot of people know about. So there's Bedford over there. Small valley, small town, excuse me. My board's mixed up. It's a little bit cold out here too. I've got to get me a jacket. But anyways, the National D-Day Memorial is dedicated to World War II veterans that fought on D-Day and lost their lives on the invasion of Normandy. So in this park, there's a lot of, attention to detail. There's a lot of small monuments in this huge monument, put it that way. There's one for the Purple Heart, and there's I don't know who he is. Let me check it out just very quickly. Clement Richard Attlee, Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, 1945-1951. So he must have been, I guess, Prime Minister after Winston Churchill. Honestly, I know my World War II history, not all of it, but I just never heard of him. I'll look into him later. But anyways, that's one bust right there, and there's another one around the corner here. And I think that's, Harry Truman. So, there's many, lot of statues, a lot of busts, a lot of just small monuments in this whole park. So, if you like adventure, please press the like button, subscribe to my channel, and turn on all notifications so you won't miss on any of my posts. So I'm gonna take a look around this park. Like I say, it's been a long time since I've been back here. So just stand by, relax, and I'll explore this park here. All right, I'm gonna take a walk here. There's a statue here. It looks like it's made of bronze. Check it out quick. Now I'm not gonna go to every single statue and show you what it looks like, because there's a lot of things in this park here. This is a gift to the National D-Day Memorial, the city of Bedford, and the nation from Guy Wildeston and his family. With our eternal gratitude to the United States of America for restoring France's freedom, for granting asylum to our parents, and for halting the extermination of a people. In memory of the American soldiers who gave their lives on the beaches of Normandy in June 1944. Yeah, so it's just some artist how created some type of it's kind of weird but interesting though. There's it looks like it's written in a different language. Anyways, there's a placard right there, but it's made of bronze. But it's just some type of art. Art doesn't always have to make sense, but it's really nice. It's interesting though. Anyways, let me get going. There's the Overlord. The infamous, not infamous, but the most famous Overlord made of marble. I remember that one. And I think right here, I don't know what this is, but it has names of people here. Let me get closer. There we go. It's on the sidewalk here. It doesn't cover the whole, stone sidewalk here, but it's got names of people here. I guess women. Vietnam, Korea. All right, this is just cobblestones. I guess people who lost their lives. Maybe they're from Bedford, Virginia. I don't know. I think that's what it is. They're from here. They were born and raised in Bedford, Virginia, and they died in combat. Maybe not. They didn't die in combat, they were just veterans. But anyways, their names all over the place. Now they don't, it doesn't cover the whole thing there, but just it goes all the way to here, to the end of the sidewalk here. As I turn around on the other side, I don't want to disturb her much, so I'm going to just go around them a little bit to give them a tour guide right there. Statue here. It's been over 20 years since I've been back here. And there's the Overlord. It's made of marble. I'm getting close to it. June 1944. Usually on days, certain days, on these flagpoles, if I'm not mistaken, they're put the Allied countries that fought with us. Their flags on these poles. So, not there today, so later on they will be. So, we'll get close to the Overlord here and check it out. This place is amazing. Like I said, it's been a long time since I've been back here. And there's the mountains in the back. This, like I said, Bedford sits in a, you know, in a valley of mountains. Of course, there are other, you know, small towns here, but Bedford's just one of those small towns that no one knows about. So, get close to the Overlord. So amazing. Yeah, it's been a long time since I've been back here. I forgot how just what an extraordinary experience this place is. Small, but still hold strong even to this day. So. Thank you. not mistaken, I think they added a little bit more to this last time I've been here. I just don't remember. There's something over there. Yeah, I don't remember that one right there. That must be new. I'll get over there later. So yeah, it's a nice beautiful day too. The trees are blooming too. Wow. Anyways. All right, this section here is kind of like a reenactment, or not reenactment, but it's like a model display of what Omaha Beach will kind of look like. So these cast, cast iron models of people, of soldiers, sailors, or Marines, either way, that came on the beaches of Omaha. Very touching here. See the guy lost his life here. See the fountains shoot up. Yeah. Make it look like they're bullets. So, showing you what Omaha Beach will look like during times of war. This placard here shows the it's actually dedicated, and it shows the participation of the U.S. Coast Guard. Now, the U.S. Coast Guard has been overlooked, especially during World War II, but they were part of the war as well. So, it's telling you about the participation of the U.S. Coast Guard during Omaha Beach situation. So. Here's a placard about the U.S. Coast Guard. I think there's an anchor here as well. I'm going to read that placard too. Yes, yeah, about the Coast Guard as well. people talk about the U.S. Navy, the Marine Corps, and the Army. But not a lot of people cover the U.S. Coast Guard. But they did their part as well. I guess this is one of the anchors from the Coast Guard's boats. But anyways, this is a display honoring the U.S. Coast Guard as well. Go on. Got the old Lord over there. I mean, there's a whole lot of placards around here. There's some placards over there as well. I may get to that later. Who knows? You know, back in 2019, I actually took, like I mentioned in another video, I actually took a trip to France, and I got to see Omaha Beach, and like in real life. So, I mean, I'm glad I did too as well. But went to see Omaha Beach, and you know, it just looks like a normal beach as of today, but it was a totally different matter long time ago. It looked, you know, that's where Omaha Beach is. What was one of the important wars or battles that were fought in World War II. It would have dictated the outcome of the war, depending who won the, you know, won that battle. So we did, and our allies as well, because the Americans weren't the only ones that, you know, stormed the Omaha Beach. You know, you had, you know, the UK and the Canadian Army as well. So, I think on that side is the American flag, Americans. And there's the right side here shows different flags of, yeah. Like I said before, there's allies over here. I guess those are the names of people that died in World War II, Omaha Beach, excuse me. And this side here is like, shows our allies as well. Yeah, it's got Great Britain, the UK, see Belgium as well. The Canadian flag, I just mentioned about Canada. Yeah, a lot of you don't realize Canada helped us as well. So we can fight, you know, the forces of evil to try to, because the Nazis, they took over France, only parts of France, not entire France, but they took over a good portion of it. And it's very crucial that we had to win the war on D-Day, because the Nazis would have advanced even further and taken over whole control of France. And then, who knows, they would have went across the Atlantic Ocean, went into the Americas, like the North America, Central America, and South America. So, yeah, the D-Day invasion was very important. That way we would not, we would be free, you know. We would not be overcome by Nazis. You know, because they had a real evil agenda. I mean, their plan was just to pretty much take over the world. So they almost did, but they didn't. So thanks to all these countries that helped us as well. head down here. There's a small park down here. I'll talk more about World War II. Now, I don't know everything about World War II, but I studied a lot about it. Give me a minute. Take me into a little tour guide over there. They got tour guides. I'm gonna look at that. Check that out. You ever come over here, there's a tour. They give tour guides as well. The Gold Star Families Memorial Monument. Just bear with me. My allergies are still bad. Not as bad like it was, what, a couple days ago? I could barely talk a couple days ago. Now I got my voice back. But pollen's still bad. But there's a monument here. This must be new. I don't remember this when I first got here back in 2000. Heavy marble. So it's a small park with benches. This whole place is peaceful, I'll tell you that much. There's a couple of generals around here. This commander in chief of the Allied Expeditionary Force, Air Force, the Air Corps back then. The Air Force didn't really come around until like after the World War II. So then back then they called the Army Air Corps. So the Army Air Corps kind of split after World War II, which were part of the U.S. Army, and they became the United States Air Force. So the Air Force was a kind of a split from the U.S. Army. And here's General Montgomery. And I don't think he was not American. Yeah, he's commander of the 21st Army. I think he was served in the Anglo-Irish War in Palestine, Egypt, and India. So he wasn't, I think he was Italian. Not mistaken, he's an Italian general. So there's Montgomery and there's a couple other generals down there, and there are some on the other side. And this right here will be General Eisenhower. He was general of the army back in the day. Now the general of the army in the United States Army is the highest ranking army and has never been used since World War II. Same thing with the United States Navy. The fleet admiral has never been used since World War II. They're both unique ranks. So General Army was used a lot, as well as the fleet admiral was used a lot back in World War II. And General Eisenhower was a fleet admiral, was general of the army at the time. And he overlooked and planned the invasion of D-Day. So it was a very hard plan to do, and there was a high risk that it would not be successful. The reason being is there was issues with low tide and high tide during in the area of the Omaha Beach area, and there was issues with the weather, and also the Nazis, their defense system was very, very robust. And it was just real good. You know, they made sure that their defense system was real, just it was good enough. It was good enough for them, it just wasn't good enough for the opposing force. So, anyways, but the problem is with the Nazis is they didn't expect any type of invasion at that spot. They didn't expect it. And also General Rommel, the the Nazi general, along with his commanding officers, were not at their post where they're supposed to be. General Rommel was actually at the rear with his family. So they gave the Nazis a disadvantage, and gave the Americans and their allied forces an advantage. Excuse me. So, anyways, Eisenhower took the chance of the weather, which was fair, and the low tide, and the timing, and struck Omaha Beach, and overcome, you know, Nazis, and history was made. So the invasion of Normandy was very successful, but it was a very, very high risk to take, especially on General Eisenhower and the American forces and their allies. So that's it about that's my spiel about General Eisenhower and invasion of Normandy. So. Alright guys, that concludes this video and me strolling through this park. I really enjoyed it. Now it's been a long time since I've been back here. I could come here the third time, the fourth time, even the fifth time. Even more than that, who knows? But if you guys really want to come here, for those who are watching this video, come to the National D-Day Memorial. I mean, especially the ones who are coming from afar off. Like, for example, maybe Florida, Montana, California, Nevada, Maine, Nebraska, whatever, even overseas. Come and see this place, National D-Day Memorial, located in a little town in Bedford, Virginia. And take a tour guide as well. I don't know everything about World War II. I study a lot of things about it, but I don't know everything. So, anyways, if you like what you see, press the like button, subscribe to this channel, and turn on all the notifications so you won't miss out on any of my posts. And until then, I'll see you in another video, all right? Thank you for watching. If you're not able to make it out to this place, you can also donate if you want. You can donate at www.dday.org or at 540-586-3329. Again, thank you so much for watching and giving.